and you're watching Down Under Derby TV.
I'm Susie from Sydney Derby Skates. We stock a wide range of products from all the best brands. Did you know that the Sydney Derby Skates website is up to date with stock levels and will only let you buy something if it's actually in stock? We pride ourselves on having awesome customer service and very quick delivery. Usually items are sent the very same day you place your order.
And we're going to be your commentators and your guides through the chaos you're about to see. We've seen two awesome games of roller derby so far. Close ones in both regards. And this one's not going to be any different. We've got Southside Derby Dolls, the Force, taking on Newcastle Roller Derby League's Dockyard Dames. Lining up for the Force today, even though it says Hawkesbury at the top. And that one says Central Coast. Lining up for the Southside today, we have Bacardi Bruiser, Freeway Fighter, Underbelly Morelli, Danny Hell, Killer B, Lethal, Sparky, Mini, Clusterfrack, Fairy Bled, Haterade, Impure Blonde, and Apocalypse. Calling the shots from the bench, we've got Colonel Panic and Lenny. Okay, so this is the Armageddon division. These two teams have met a couple of times in the past and have a fairly recent history. The only two times they've played, first time was in September last year, Newcastle taking out a win by about 12, 15 points, so a nice and close one. They met again at the Bont Invitational only in January, and Newcastle turned it up and really put a beating on Southside, beating them by about 200 points. So far in their two matches, Newcastle having the wood over Southside, but look for Southside to exact some revenge today. Absolutely. Well, Southside are the defending champions two times. Each time this event has been run since 2013, 2014, Southside has taken out the top division. Now, in round one, Icy, you got to play Southside.
Yeah.
Tell us about your experience there. It's going to be a great game to watch. Lots of names to look out for. If we pick just a couple, you're not really going to get the full breadth of what's going on. But just so you know, on Southside, the Forces side, there are two skaters in particular, Sparky and Clusterfrack, have been called up from the B team, the Empire at Southside. So they're making their debut in 5x5 for the Force. They have played with the team previously. Sparky traveled to the Great Southern Slam as an alternate with the Force. Clusterfrack played with, they both played in Bont in January as well. So they are new to 5x5, but not new to the team. Wollongong.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah.
Wollongong, yeah. Absolutely. So jam number one about to get underway, stepping up to the jammer line. Stepping up to the jammer line for jam one, we have Debris for Newcastle, 737 in the purple and yellow.
Danny Hell, 23 for Southside. I got to jam against her last time. Now, she does not make it easy.
Now, another thing people might like to know at home, Danny Hell, who's just picked up lead jammer, former skater for Newcastle. She's a long-time Dockyard Dame up with Newcastle, moved to Sydney and joined Southside. She's got lead jammer at the moment and looking for points. Debris now out on her scoring pass and approaching quickly.
Danielle takes the opportunity to call it, cutting off any chance for Debris to get any points. Southside come away with, it looks like three, but we'll get it confirmed by...
Danny Hell getting on the board for Southside, 3 points to zero. Thunder Slut now on the line for Newcastle. And a big shout out to Mama Slut, actually. Thunder said she'd be watching from home, so I said, should I call her Mama Slut? Because I feel really wrong saying that. She said, absolutely.
The things that these Derby girls' names make me say, I'm never quite sure about it. Jam 2 is underway. A lot of sidewards movement from our Southside jammer, battling it out the front.
And so Freely Fighter pushes her way through to lead jammer for Southside. She's got lead jammer once again. Thunderslut finding some room, one to beat, and gets through. She's on a scoring pass.
Some really nifty little footwork out the front just to flick her hips in front of that last blocker and get free. We have 2 points to S2. From the end of that jam, very, very tight, short jams already. You can tell that the blockers are working as hard as they can to keep those really strong jammers controlled, but they are getting out really quickly one after the other, which is, I love when Derby's played like that, I think. It keeps the scores tight, it keeps the action really fast.
Strong defensive walls, not giving up many points, seems to be the theme of the day.
Yeah.
The first game, just snipers versus varsity, some amazing walls and defensive play. We might see more of that here. We know that Southside's definitely capable of it from their round one win over the Snipers. So,
yeah. No, they were definitely working some really strong formations during that first game. And it's also something that we've been working on and have noticed other teams working on. Varsity were not making it easy. They were having a lot of three walls and things rotating, a lot of dynamic walls, really slowing jammers down. We're not seeing anywhere near the amount of sort of 20, 30-point passes that you would have seen this time last year.
Well, so far in this game, we've only just gotten started, but limited to one pass every time. 8 points now for Southside. They've gotten three lead jammers in a row, but not able to break out for any more than one pass. So showing that the defense is doing its job, but also offense getting their jammers through fairly quickly.
It's one of the gorgeous things about the Derby game is just how fast it evolves. This game doesn't look the same from when I started 2 years ago.
So Freely Fighter jamming once again for Southside up against Thunderslut for Newcastle.
She's battling it out. She has made it clear she is not lead jammer, but she is coming around. Freely Fighter just blitzing past the Newcastle blockers there for a 4-point pass. Manages to catch it up and calls it off before Thunderslut can put any points on the board. We now have S2D2 on 12 and Newcastle on 0.
So we're four jams in and it's all Southside at the moment. 12 points to 0. Southside off to a cracking start.
So this formation that we've got Southside seeing, that was Thunderslut getting around the last two, busting out, battling her way through some really strong S2 defense.
Jam number five underway. Debris jamming once again for Newcastle. Apocalypse with the star for Southside.
So So Newcastle have got lead for the first time in this game, their first jam, and they have just made their first scoring pass, calling it off before S2 can get around and answer with any points of their own. That is a four-point pass for Newcastle.
So Newcastle now on the board. It took four jams to get there. Let's see if this will start a roll on for Newcastle.
It was a really good bit of offense.
Butterflies out, I guess, finding their groove.
The replay there showing a really good bit of lateral offense to get the Newcastle jammer out and get those points. Bit of a tumble on the Newcastle jammer right at the start. She's going to have to go straight back into that wall, but she has managed to sneak up the inside and power around. She's not lead. Lead is to Danny Hell, who has just entered the pack. Moving very, very nice footwork to get out 4 points and calls it.
So Danny Hell showing some fancy feet, and again, hit it and quit it. Strategy, one pass, no more for both teams.
So I've got, I feel a bit of an affinity with Danny Hell because we're both number 23, but I went up against her and yeah, it wasn't my best jam. She did really well though, which
Danny
is great.
Hell will make you work for her for sure.
See, this is the sort of triangle formation S2 have got up the front here with their pivot holding their outside arms. If it works right, it has this amazing ability to spin and really block off the inside and outside lanes. And they are doing that exceptionally well, drawing the Newcastle jammer back. The trick to it is reforming, and it looks like they're having a hard time there, getting scattered, and the Newcastle jammer is out. She is not lead jammer. Freeway Fighter has made it around.
So another 4 points on the board for Southside via Freeway Fighter. 100% lead jammer status for Freeway Fighter so far.
And a very solid 20 points on the board. I don't think they have had a jam where they've come away empty-handed.
No, just, yeah.
Maybe just that one
just
with NRDL.
One with
just
the
one.
Lead.
I'd like to take the opportunity to give a quick shout out to our sponsors, Sydney Derby Skates, and also to the Sydney Dogs and Cats Home. Rescued is my favorite breed.
So this jam starts with Thunderslut jamming for Newcastle. High rotation with a short lineup. We're going to see a lot of Thunderslut, a lot of debris today. And Danny Hill also in high rotation, getting lead jammer once again for Southside in teal.
They both are very much on their game at the moment, forcing those blockers to really reconsider how they're going to approach them.
So 2 points in that last one.
The replay showing Thunderslut coming through just at the end.
Next jam begins. Debris jamming again for Newcastle. And Freeway Fighter lead jammer once more for Southside. She's got a couple of strides on debris, but debris giving chase.
Jammer on jammer action is the most favorite phrase. Massive hit there.
A risky play from Freeway Fighter and getting pinged for the penalty. Power jam, first one of the game. This one going to Newcastle.
She went to the box for a forearm penalty. But she did have leads, so this means we have a two-minute jam. It's going to go till the end. Freeway is going to get out of the box. We've just got to make sure. Well, Newcastle would be really at a... be a really good idea for them to take this opportunity to get some serious points on the board before they have to contend with another jammer.
Southside doing a good job so far, hitting debris out and dragging it the long way back. Close to 30 seconds wiped off already, and Freeway Fighter back on the track. Only one scoring pass for debris.
S2 forming their formation, getting ready.
And Freeway Fighter making up for it already, grabbing points on the way out of the box.
A very delicious inside line opening up there, just while everybody's a little bit messed up, I think. They're having trouble getting their walls back together.
Well, there was a star pass there. K-Sass now jamming for Newcastle. Looks like Debris really had it taken out of her. Maybe from the big hit that Freeway Fighter was taking.
I wouldn't be surprised. She had absolutely zero parts of her on the floor at one point there.
So Freeway Fighter gave up the power jam, went to the penalty box, but is now leading this jam 13-5.
I'm never going to encourage people to make risky moves and go to the penalty box, but sometimes the maths does work out.
So strong recovery there from the force and extending their lead. 35 plays 9 after 9 jams now. Southside firmly in control. 10 minutes gone in this first half. We've still got a long way to go, but so far Southside looking impressive.
Looks like we have Apocalypse wearing the jammer stuff for the first time today for Southside.
So this was a game, I'm not sure if you're aware, but 5x5, the only one in the world that I'm aware of, are running a tipping comp for all the fans out there. So you get to pick who do you think will win the game, who do you think will have the highest scoring jammer, what the total score difference will be, and what the point differential will be at the end of the season. So the tipster with the highest score wins a massive merch pack, including merch from all 10 leagues. So this game would have been a difficult one to pick, I'm sure. And none of the games are really all that easy, especially when you come into take into consideration total score and differential, all that sort of thing.
Oh, absolutely. And you've got to weigh up S2's absolute grit, how well they did in the first game, versus their history, existing history against Newcastle.
Yeah, absolutely. This one is going to be a good one. Keep tuned to this station, folks. Of course, during in between halftime and in between games, we've got all the other content coming out of 5x5. Halftime of this game, Snack Life will be coming to you, where we review snacks. So Apocalypse jamming for Southside. She gets lead once again. Thunderslide hit to the outside. Lethal doing a good job of keeping her there.
See, S2 forming this sort of a four, it's like a square-shaped defense wall, and it's an amazingly adaptive formation. But you have to have some massive trust for your fellow blockers to know that they will go there. It's something that we've been seeing VRDL playing a lot of, and it's something that they used and did really well with when they played at Champs last year.
Yeah, geometric derby playing its part. Freeway Fighter, a lot of success so far in this game. She steps up to the line again. Number 187 for Southside in teal. Up against Booger, giving her signature signal to the crowd. Number 16 in the purple and gold.
Extraordinarily strong force on track, Booger. Very, very hard to hold. And she goes just absolutely pummeling through that Southside wall, making a round, earning lead jammer in the process, but she is not far behind by Freeway Fighter. I'll be amazed if there's any points in this. If she's good, Freeway will be able to force her to call it off, and there it is.
Yeah, Booger not wanting to risk any points going Freeway's way. First time today, Freeway Fighter not lead jammer. Booger stamping her authority on that jam.
The replay there just showing Booger's amazing charge through the Southside defense and her last little shimmy past the pivot. Thunderslide is back on track, jamming against Danny Hell. These two are going to meet up a few times during this game, I think. I think this is going to...
Absolutely.
I want it to become a grudge. I want comic books to be made about it. Danny Hell is doing a sneaky little wriggle around to get out. She has been very quickly awarded lead.
Lead jammer once again.
At the back, wriggling around. She has been sent to the box for a cut track call.
So first power jam here for Southside. Danny Hill with a chance to extend the lead.
We know she can do it, but she's having a hard time against those last couple of Newcastle players. They ended up having to let her go.
There's 5 points already. Danny Hell on the hunt for more now. Assist from Bacardi Bruiser. She plays anchor. Southside doing a good job of keeping the pack at a standstill. 20-foot rule applies, and Danny Hill let go for another 5 points.
Thunderslut's just coming back on track. Be interesting to see if Southside have clocked it and they have reformed. Trying to catch her. Thunderslut sneaking around the inside with a little bit of a transition, making it out. Now she's got to chase down Danielle, see if she can put a stop to this point scoring.
So Danielle does have lead. And Thunderslut coming fast into the pack. And Danielle trusting her wall here to hold Thunderslut. Maybe give up a couple of points in order to get five more.
Yeah, Fairy Blood there battling it out with Thunderslut right at the back. Feeding her up into the south side formation. They've got a little triangle going. Thunderslut had the hardest time against south side just now. And the crowd really enjoyed that jam.
Yeah, big jam there for south side. And the south side faithful in the crowd. They call them the Rebel Alliance, letting their skaters know how much they love them.
That jam was 24 to Southside, 3 to Newcastle. It's an absolutely massive jam. It's going to be difficult for Newcastle to close the gap, but from what we see from Thunderslut and Booger, they can definitely get out there and get lead and take control of these jams. Exhibit A, Booger charging right through the defense. Massive strides as she comes right screaming back into the Southside defense.
So Booger having a lot of success in her two jams so far. I expect that we'll probably see a lot more of her out there.
And that was a very successful hit it and quit it campaign. She got herself into the mess of the Southside jammers, calling it off before they had a chance to pinch any points from her. She ended up getting 3 for that jam.
So 3 points for Booger in that one. 64 plays 23. We are past the halfway mark in this first period here.
Yeah, Freeway Fighter back on track for Southside in a little bit of a pile-up. She was moving back and forth trying to draw the Newcastle wall to either side and open up some gaps. She has taken her helmet panty off.
So star
which worked
pass.
Really well for her. What they call it, the star stash.
Yeah.
So you take it off, they think you're going for a star pass. You just put it straight back on.
Vanilla Bean Witherly Jammer calls it off when she looks over at the bench and prevents any points going Southside's way. So strong defensive jamming there from Southside. Didn't get lead, but forced the call off.
They're going to have to come at this points differential in two different ways. They're going to have to shut down their jammers. So by Newcastle, they're going to have to shut down S2's jammers and also give theirs a really good run for it. They've done a really good job in that last jam.
Just do it.
They just do it. Yeah. Yeah, so it's two steps.
Easily
you know.
Said.
Stop their jammer, let your jammer through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. They didn't do it because Apocalypse now lead jammer for Southside. Booger back on the track as I predicted. We'll be seeing a lot more of her, but picking up a track cut forced by Southside. So power jam here for Apocalypse.
Danielle screaming out of the pack there.
And 5 points already for Apocalypse before Booger even hits the box. So another scoring pass.
Newcastle need to get their defensive walls together because Apocalypse is just charging through them. Reforming quickly before the jammer comes around is something that both of these teams it'd be really good for them to do.
We see a lot of different styles of jamming, Icy. The fast feet, the quick, small, agile, and then you have the brute strength, the blocking style of jamming, and Apocalypse making good use of that style.
Oh yeah, both Booger and Apocalypse are very good at just going in and really smashing up those walls, making it very, very hard for them to reform around them. Oh!
Another track cut forced on Booger. Mini forcing that track cut.
but a very commendable effort by Booger there, trying to stay in line, in bounds. She had very close. Unfortunately, she was not quite aware of who she needed to come back in behind, so she jumped back on track and ended up with a cut. So that means Southside get to start with a power jam, which is not a position Newcastle wanted to put themselves in right now when they're trying to really slow it down. There's a clean 60 points differential in it, and we are only 11 minutes away from the end of this first half.
So pivot line start from the teams here, something we don't see all that often. Sparky now jamming for Southside. She's got a big opportunity here.
I've noticed that Sparky's got this little like shoulder shimmy that she does as part of her sort of juking thing. Come in and tries to fake out and does a little wriggle and then hits the wall. A little bit of a late assist there from Southside, trying to make it a little bit easier for Sparky, but it doesn't seem to have worked. She's up against a three wall, trying to bridge her out for as long as possible, but she is wriggling around those last two. She is, if she can stay in bounds.
That's the longest 20 feet I've ever seen.
Yeah, I feel for her so much.
Sparky,
so
getting
much.
5 points though.
Booger struggling at the back, has just passed the star to her pivot, who is now into a three wall of Southside's.
Now, if you watched the stream from home in round number one, you would have seen Sparky playing the violin with the Game of Thrones theme tune. She's a YouTube sensation. Look up Lara plays video games, video game music, sorry, and watch Sparky in a very different light.
Derby people always surprise me. I recently learned somebody I play with is a French horn in an orchestra. There you go.
She's what they call internet famous. There's Derby famous.
There's Derby famous.
There's definitely Derby famous.
Internet famous.
There's internet famous. And then there's just actual famous.
And there's actual famous famous. I'd be happy with internet famous.
Yeah,
I think that'd
I'm
be
sure
nice.
She is.
Yeah. Danielle jamming again for Southside up against a very solid three of the Newcastle blockers. They are bracing off each other, really trying to slow her down, but she is pounding her feet away and manages to sneak up the outside for lead.
Vanilla Bean not finding the same success. She's stuck at the back of this Southside wall, doing a good job keeping there. Danielle now looking for points.
Vanilla Bean is now out of the pack, but right behind her, one pass ahead, is Danny Hell. Oh, I really hope that she messes with her a little. Oh. It's a rare and beautiful thing when two jammers meet up on the track.
So again, Danny Hell keeping the jam going, and Colonel Panic for Southside giving the signal to keep it going. Happy to give away a couple of points, knowing that their blockers have the best of it so far.
Mm-hmm.
So that's 1 5-point pass for the three that they've given away. Here comes another one with Danny Hell back in the pack.
At this point in the game, with this much of a lead, it comes down to maintaining control of the time. And so you may find that it works out better to run the jams a little bit longer. Maybe you do lead. End up with like a 20-point jam to a 5-point jam.
Exactly.
But this, you have kept control of the clock.
This shows the other side of the coin here. Danny Hill picking up a track cut now. So power jam to Vanilla Bean and Newcastle.
Only 25 seconds left in the jam though. So Vanilla Bean is going to have to work pretty hard to make a massive impact from that.
So there has been a star pass. Thunderslut stashing it. She's the pivot. Thunderslut picking up points while stashing the helmet cover. Very interesting call there.
Be interesting to see if that goes to an official review. But this is the other side of it. This is the kind of side of the game where your bench squad are watching it, thinking about how to call the jams at different times to take advantage of the clock and use the clock in that way. And also Absolutely. Paying attention to things like opportunities for official reviews, which there may have been one there.
So Apocalypse now jamming for Southside. Debris with the honours for Newcastle. She's got lead jammer. And Newcastle, the last jam going their favour, looking to add to it here and chip away at this lead coming into halftime.
Southside not getting their defence together in time. Newcastle's jammer coming through, busting a very neat hole, trying to not lose her footing on the outside as she comes around. Calling it as she hits the wall. Neat little fist bump there from Southside.
Very generous. So 109 plays 40. Newcastle coming back a little bit against Southside's attack here. Mini now jamming for the first time today for Southside, co-captain of the Force, up against Thunderslut.
And we have an official timeout is over. Been
so don't forget, folks, Sydney Derby Skates, proud sponsor of the 5x5 stream. They are having a mega sale at the moment, so check them out. And of course, Flash Ramps, proud sponsor of the 5x5 stream. Also, custom made skate ramps, like quarter pipes, mini ramps, grind benches, all that sort of thing. Buy a 5x5 skater, Flashbird from Northern Beaches.
Thunderslut just made a massive attempt to go up the inside line. Very, very fast, very hard. Got knocked down and recycled. In the meantime, Southside have managed to get lead. And that was their first scoring pass coming round. Thunderslut still fighting, has just managed to make it out of the pack.
So Thunderslut grabbing lead jammer status there. Mini, no pass, no penalty, but she did grab 5 points.
Thunderslut shutting it down as soon as she could. Newcastle starting a little bit light on the track. Two of their blockers are in the box.
So pack advantage to Southside here.
So if you
Debris
can see,
with the star for Newcastle.
So if you can see the shape that Southside have formed, they've got a... Oh, it's actually a really good example of it. I'm so happy. they started with two people facing backwards and then moved into this beautiful square formation. And this is something that a lot of the leagues have been working towards, is really dynamic geometric derby.
So Debris still on her initial sparky, picking up 5 points there. She's got lead jammer for Southside. And a track cut forced on Debris. So power jam here for Sparky and Southside.
So also going up against a skinny blocker lineup. A lot of Newcastle blockers are also in the box. I think they have two down from where I'm sitting, making it quite easy for Sparky to split them up and wriggle around. There's some amazing footwork there. A quick little hop skip through for another 5 points. This is a 15-point jam so far.
So Sparky, another opportunity for points here. Five more on offer. Trying to find a gap in that two wall. Marilyn Tantrum.
Newcastle doing a fantastic job. That little dynamic two wall that they were working on was a really solid effort.
And it
really
worked well
it
because
down.
Forcing a track cut on Sparky there. So power jam back to Newcastle now.
Southside staying together and strong, making it very hard for Debris to battle out the front of there. Bridging her out right to the last foot.
Debris, chance here for points.
15 seconds to try and close that gap. Newcastle have their pivot back on track. They are back to four blockers. Hopefully going to get in there and make some big assists for their jammer, but they are hanging back, which I think is such mixed feelings about passive offense.
Especially against a wall like what Southside's been putting out.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just leaving the jammer out the front there.
Especially when Newcastle really don't have the luxury of letting opportunities go past them at this point.
Yeah,
Another shout out to one of our sponsors, the Sydney Dogs and Cats Home.
So another power gem star for Newcastle here, Booger with the star. Sparky standing in the box and making her way back onto the track shortly.
Booger having a lot of success earlier with busting straight through those south side walls. Looks like south side have really tightened it up. That was a really nice three-wall defense. Booger had to fight for that.
So Booger maybe coming with the element of surprise, and south side now working it out and figuring, you know, adjusting what they're doing.
Definitely. I think that time they had a little bit more space to work with. They could see Booger coming and also a bit of a chance to dig right in with their wheels and cut off her speed. So many jammers will come in hot, and the shock and the power that they come in with is going to be enough to bust your walls open. So you've just got to really dig and be prepared to be basically hit from behind by a freight truck. You know?
You sound like you speak from experience.
Oh, it's so much. it's one thing I brace for, and it's one thing I try and do when I'm jamming as well.
So Kay Sass now with the star for Newcastle. She's pushing up the front, transfer from Auckland Roller Derby League. Minnie going with her though. She's out, both jammers on their scoring path now, stride for stride.
Both jammers very fast, very beautiful form as they come around the track. I'm very impressed.
Bacardi Bruiser laying out Kay Sass at the back there. You talked about coming in with a bit too hot into the pack, and then just running into a stationary wall dropping.
There's a lot of things that people try. You sort of go in sideways, try and go in with a hip. They call it things like the knife or the saw, and you come in really, really hot and sort of go very hard for those legal target zones. Of course, if you're the person receiving that kind of punishment, it can be very, very
well. Bacardi Bruiser looked like she was ready for it,
yeah,
and just dropped her.
A well-timed counter hit is something very, very satisfying. I did get the opportunity to do that in my first game, and with 5x5, and I'm not ashamed to say I looked at that bit of the footage over and over again a few times. I didn't have my best jamming time that first game, so I'm fine.
One of those automatic gift sites where you can just make a GIF and watch it.
You know what? They should alternate, you know, for every GIF of me not doing the thing I'm meant to be doing, they should have two of me doing the thing I'm doing. And then it's like a really good self-esteem boost. And then I also develop as a player.
There you go.
Yeah. I think
always learning, always improving.
We're a very entrepreneurial bunch. I'm sure somebody could start a website where that's what they do.
Well, Southside in control of this one, 133 to 53. So 80 points in control going into halftime. We got 30 seconds on the clock for the first half. Freeway Fighter pulling on the star for Southside, and Booger once again stepping up to the line.
I've been enjoying these two jammers a great deal, especially seeing Booger charge through those walls. It really is, in some cases, the only thing. Right in front of our feet, we have pure energy,
pure energy
from Sydney. Hey, buddy.
So we are coming up to halftime. Official timeout in play. Captains talking it over. Bench coaches with Axiom Addict, head referee.
Our beautiful crowd, holler out to the Sydney peeps right there. And the massive crew for CCRG who made the hike here. And then Southside with their incredible audience support that they always have.
The Rebel Alliance from Southside.
The Rebel Alliance.
Always loud. Booger wants a beat in
Hater Road. Through. I do love that. Closely followed by Freeway Fighter. What's not going to be a very long jam, I think. If Booger can hit it and quit it, it's going to be the best thing for her.
Well, Newcastle set up at the back. Points potential here for Freeway Fighter.
Booger signalling her blockers to get in front, try and get the pack to slow down that she could nab some points, but the way the packs were on track just then, it was not in Booger's favour. It was definitely Freewee's opportunity.
So timeout called by Southside right before the game clock finished up.
And that's the other side of the game, isn't it? That's our sneaky bench coach side of the game calling a timeout with 2 seconds left. As long as there is time on the period clock, there will be a jam.
We saw in the first game today, Varsity versus Snipers, the bench coach for Varsity, Sheriff, using the new official review, but really I just want a timeout play in the first half. So, of course, you're allowed 3 timeouts per game, but 1 official review per half. So why not use the official review in that manner if you haven't used it already and save your timeouts for when you might need them?
Especially if it's gone unused. Of course, if you use an official review and it is refused, you lose the official review, but if you use it and it's correct, you get it back. Yep. So, yeah, if it comes down to the end of the half and it's just sitting there begging.
Just use it.
But very sneaky. Denny Hill jamming for Southside. Up against a number 49, Kay Sass for Newcastle. It's very unusual in our game so far to have the jammer lead be called so late. Normally they've been busting through right before that front turn, but they didn't come out until the other straightaway. They're right on top of each other. Southside have lead, but I don't know how many points they're going to get if it is so tight. Danielle trying to eke out a couple of points, but
so Sass picking up points against the lead there, and we go into oranges 138-56. Southside in control. We'll be back in about 15 minutes, but stay tuned to the stream for Snack Life coming shortly.
We stock a wide range of products from all the best brands. Did you know that the Sydney Derby Skates website is up to date with stock levels and will only let you buy something if it's actually in stock? We pride ourselves on having awesome customer service and very quick delivery. Usually items are sent the very same day you place your order.
Welcome back to the second half of our game with Southside versus Newcastle. We've jumped straight back into it with whatever's been said to Newcastle in that half has worked because Booger has got lead jammer. Danielle just making it out, not lead jammer. How was Snack Life there?
I'm back from double duty. Snack Life is always good. We've still got a bunch of stuff left over, so we might do another version of it. Maybe in between this game, I don't know. See what we can do.
I did one of those funny little jelly lolly things with the bits in it. I'm not sure. I'm really unsure about what's happening in my system right now.
So we're seeing up on the board now, on the screen, sorry, points per jam. I'm assuming the top team was Southside. But 140 plays 59. Southside starting the second half as they did the first. Lots of lead jammer and lots of points. Freeway Fighter now with the star. She's looking to add to a tally. She top scored in the entire round in round one. Maybe looking to repeat that here against Newcastle.
No doubt. She's certainly on track to do so. Pun intended, absolutely. Vanilla Bean is now in the pack. Not Lee Jammer. She's only just become eligible to score points. Danny Hill making it around. One more pass as leads. Vanilla Bean coming up to the S2 wall, trying to scratch a few more points out. She gets knocked to the inside of the track. S2, their tight little two-wall defense, hand class. They form into a three. This is what we're talking about with the geometric defense. Reforming at the front, trying to close her off.
So that was another five-point pass for Freeway Fighter. Offense out the wazoo so far for her. Untouched through the pack, just then another 5 points. Southside pouring on the points at the moment. Star pass. And an illegal procedure for the star pass. Okay, Sass on the way to the box. Vanilla Flicky Bean forced to retake up the star.
Southside forming up at the front into what we call a rainbow wall, but every league seems to have a different word for it. It's when you've got inside and outside facing backwards, bracing off of the two in the middle. It's a really adaptive wall shape, and as you can see, it makes it really, really hard. Gemma's like Vanilla Bean, who's sort of moving laterally. There's always somebody there and always somebody being reinforced. You end up with two layers of defense covering an entire track. It's really tricky.
So that was a 29-point jam for Freeway Fighter without a power jam.
Understandably very pleased with herself, as she should be. 29-4.
If you can. Thanks, Ed.
Danielle is back on track, jamming against Booger. A little bit of a tap. Danielle gave Booger a tap just as they were coming up to the walls. The walls are being starting out quite spread between the jammer and the pivot lines. It's giving the jammers a really good chance to run up and get some power before they engage with them. Danielle coming around on a scoring pass. Booger just out, not lead jammer. Bridging back, the south side are bridging back the Newcastle defense as a way to bust them up, give an assist to Danielle, who makes it through one more pass. A very neat 110-point lead to Southside at this point.
Southside showing their dominance so far in this game. Newcastle not having a lot of answers for it. 173 to 63. And Danny Hill adding to her tally there once again.
A new jam. That's Thunderslap pushing very aggressively against the south side wall, forcing them to turn around. A little bit of a pile up. Thunderslap goes down, forced to re-enter behind the south side two wall at the back. They are not quite fast enough. Thunderslap trying to cut up the outside. She is successful, but lead has already gone to Apocalypse, who is coming around for a scoring pass. And she calls it off. She gets knocked to the outside of the track and calls it off before Thunderslap has a chance to get round and put any points on the board for Newcastle in this half.
So Southside, perfect so far in the second half, not giving up any points to Newcastle.
So this formation that the Southside are in, this is what we would call a rainbow. I've also heard it called a Texas. I think it's also been called a VR wall because of like VRDL Sorry. Wall. Because of VRDL being the first league to sort of really play with these dynamic wall formations. It's really exciting to see it filter down into our leagues, and it's really upping the level of Derby. Jammers are having to rethink how they attack these walls because the blockers are trusting each other way more, and it's so much harder to bust them up when they're hanging onto each other. And we can see that with the scores are lower. They're so, apart from the amazing 29-point jam we just saw, that is a rarity now.
Yeah, absolutely. Freeway Fighter looking to add to that in this one. She's already got five and calls it off. Freeway Fighter, Southside picking up a lead once again.
Freeway Fighter having a fantastic time on track. Some well-earned congratulations from KP just there. You can see her coming up to the wall in this replay and just really picking her gaps wisely. Newcastle not having a chance to reform before she hits them.
Apocalypse now jamming fourth Southside up against K-Sass for Newcastle.
Okay, Sass has a little bit of trouble getting through her own wall at the start there. They were very tightly packed.
Neither jammer finding any holes at the moment. One to beat, and Kay Sass getting through. Lead jammer for Newcastle.
They're going to want to take a really good advantage of this. Apocalypse still in the pack on her initial pass. She went down, took a little bit of time to get up. Looks like she might be having a bit of grief with her knee. Thunderslut taking her on immediately, slowing her down, trying to stop her having any kind of wiggle room. K-Sass coming through on a scoring pass. That is a Grand Slam pass. Second Grand Slam pass for Newcastle. They'll be very happy with that.
So a big jam here for the Novocastrians, exactly what they want.
Star pass. Huge chase down attempt, tackle there from Thunderslut. The timing wasn't quite right.
Star pass for Southside. Haterade takes off with the star in her hand and forces the call off from Kay Sass. So big jam there for Newcastle, 11-0.
This is the amazing thing about Dobie. If they can, whatever they just did, if they can bottle that, and then come back to it again and again. Just a few points here, just start a bleed, lock down the points from Southside, and just chip away, you know, 4 points here, 3 points there. You can actually close this kind of gap, and it does happen very convincingly. So by no means, you know, 21 minutes left in the game, they can still definitely make a difference.
And there's Danny Hill shooting out to lead jammer for Southside.
Danielle coming back up. The Newcastle blockers are a little bit frazzled. They're not really reforming in time to close her down. KP saying, keep going to Danielle. Booger wants to know where her blockers are, hanging out the front, coming into a brace, getting ready to lock down Danielle, but she has got some assists with her, busting it up. So that was 9 points to Southside in that jam. Four going to Newcastle. I would say Southside would be able to keep churning up the points and just keep cranking up that point differential.
Well, history so far in this game has shown that Newcastle, although flashes of brilliance, haven't really been able to find consistency in getting through that wall. And again, Freeway Fighter gets through, lead jammer.
Going wide and then cutting back in on turn two. When Freeway Fighter comes up against the Newcastle walls, she's doing a really good job of sort of stringing them out and getting a few meters between each of them. And then she'll cut back in from the outside of the outer apex of the turn and just take advantage of one of those gaps that she made. So as far as the blockers know, like, yeah, we're together, we're in a wall, but instead, you know, laterally, she's actually pulled some quite big gaps open. I'm using my hands, which is fantastically not useful for her feet, but
we
you can see what's happening on track. She's going to do it again. She's, yeah.
Well, Danny Hill with a chance here now for Southside.
I am loving Southside's little triangle formation here. The way they turn in, the jammer tries to take the outside. They spin in on her.
Oh, Bacardi Bruiser lines it up and nails debris. And Danny Hill, Lee Jammer.
Debris so close to making Lee Jammer, but Bacardi Bruiser just nailing her as she tried to sneak up the outside line. Danielle calling it off.
So that brings up the 200 point mark for Southside. Tip their bat to the audience. 202 plays 80. Southside putting on a performance here today.
Thunderslap back on track, jamming for Newcastle. Freeway Fighter already out the front battling the Newcastle wall. She has got a lead and she is coming around. Thunderslide just getting out. Denny Held has enough time to squeak some more points before calling it off, seeing if she can chase down. KP's telling her to keep it going, even though Thunderslide is now coming round on her scoring pass right into that solid four wall that Southside have gotten together, and they have really tightened that up over this game.
So Freeway Fighter is on a scoring pass here. And there's 4 points each.
Thunderslide being a bit cheeky.
Well, last time Freeway tried that, she got pinged for the penalty. Takes it a little bit easier this time round and calls it off.
We have had to ask the refs in the past, you know, what is the penalty for snogging somebody on track? Is it going counted as going in with the head, or is it counted as
it's gross misconduct.
Booger jamming against Apocalypse, meeting up once again on the jammer line. Apocalypse wriggling out the front up against a pretty strong Newcastle wall, but she manages to disintegrate them. They go back to help assist Booger to get out. She's on her own up the front. We have seen her charge through walls like this, but I know it's getting a little bit late in the game.
But Southside doing a hell of a job of counteracting that. Lethal, the last one. And now Booger is out. But in the meantime, Apocalypse picked up a 5-point pass for Lappinger.
Southside doing everything they can to hold that jammer until the very last foot that they have to.
So one thing that I do like for Newcastle, although maybe not all that successful just yet, They're playing with a fairly short lineup, but what that means is they're experimenting. They're throwing out jammers that wouldn't normally be jamming just to see what might work. And if someone has a little bit of success, we'll go with that again. So K-Sass didn't jam all that much in the first, had a big jam. Now she's, you know, jamming a lot more. And they're trying. They're trying different things and finding gaps, but so far not finding the answer. But if they keep experimenting, they might do.
They absolutely will, and this is the beauty of the, you know, these geometric formations coming in. Jammers are being forced to really have a think about how they approach walls. You know, jammers that up until recently had a lot of success just being strong and just punching through, that's just not going to work anymore because all of these blocking formations have got extra lines of resistance. You know, they brace off each other, they hold each other. So the solid jammers have to be more jukey. The jukey jammers have to be more solid. Otherwise, they're just going to get swept. It's a really exciting time. There's this arms race going on between the blockers and the jammers.
Yeah,
and it's
absolutely.
Just developing
and
so
and we're
fast.
Seeing it across all levels now. When you notice our Battlegrounds division is the lower division, but the level of play that they're pulling out, they may not be as skilled or as strong, but they're knowing what to do a lot of the times and trying these different things, which is really fascinating to watch.
And it's one of the things that makes this game so awesome is that it's just so dynamic and so young. It's still figuring itself out, and everybody tries to one-up each other every single time in terms of skill, in terms of technique and approach. You know, the game is not the same from one year to the next.
So right now, Danny Hill in control of this jam, picking up points again, 5 in fact, and calls it off with her hands on her hips. Southside up to 237 to 88 now. We pass the 14-minute mark and coming into the last quarter of this game, Debris with a challenge ahead of her now for Newcastle, stepping up to the line against Apocalypse, jamming for Southside.
Another thing that we've started to see is these pivot line starts, you know, as people try and do different things to hold jammers or give their jammers a bit of an edge. It's really interesting to see things like the pivot line start cut coming back. All of Newcastle rushing back to recycle Apocalypse. Very successful forced cut track there on Apocalypse.
Yeah, Mojo Malicious forcing the track cut.
Very quick work, some fantastic track awareness there. Southside looking very serious, resisting the assist that's coming in for Debris. Debris managing to create a little bit of a gap there between the backwards and forward blockers.
Give a hand signal to her blockers to clear a path and do the assist. It worked well. 5 points for Debris and Newcastle. This time, though, skating by herself with a lot more resistance.
That's one thing we've also seen becoming pretty standard is as you bridge out the blockers from the pack, you know, you're wanting to try and keep your blockers able to hold the jammer for as long as possible. So, you know, you stretch it out. Very, very rarely are we seeing just one blocker being left alone. You know, everybody's sort of decided that two is the best way to have the best line of defense at the end there. And
so that 10-point pass there from Debris brought them up to the ton. 100 points on the board for Newcastle now.
137 points is the lead that Southside has over Newcastle.
So again, Southside repeating the success they had in the first round and beating Snipers by about 133, I think the differential was. Now going past that for now, see what Newcastle can do to trim back that score, because we don't know how that might play out come playoffs in August, at the end of the season. Point differential will play, point differential can kick. We saw it last year with two teams tied on points. Point differential mattered and determined who played the grand final and who didn't.
Thunderslut fighting so hard for her points out the front there. Is forced a cut. Some fantastic track awareness there by the Southside blockers.
So Apocalypse with the power play now and a chance to push even more into the towards the 300 point mark. Good movement from Newcastle. Bridging out, 20-foot rule kicking in as Southside brings the pack to a standstill and Apocalypse keeps on skating.
Booger doing her thing with some really solid defense on track, ends up going to the box for blocking out of play.
Thunderslut makes her way back on the track and joins Apocalypse in stride for stride. Still on her initial though, so see if Apocalypse lets her have some leeway here.
Colonel Panic signaling to his jammer that she can get one more. Apocalypse calls it. It really can be a little bit tricky when you're jamming and your opposition jammer goes to the box and you've got lead. You don't really know what pass they went to the box on. Sometimes it can be just a really good idea to cover your butt and call it, but it's not a great feeling when you come off and you realize, oh, she was on her initial.
Yeah. I mean, you kind of got other stuff to worry about at that point, don't you?
Yeah.
Like maybe, you know, not getting hit.
Yeah, right.
Stuff like that. And a freeway fighter not getting hit. She gets through lead jammer once again for Southside.
Not missing a chance. Debris not far behind her, though. Not fast enough to prevent that scoring pass.
So Debris on a scoring pass. She gets this freeway fighter, gets a signal, however, to keep it going.
This is a very fast and messy pack. Both of the jammers are just wriggling through with relative ease, and it's a little bit it's a little bit different to the blocking that we've seen so far, which has been quite controlled.
So Free Fighter looking to catch debris here. Free Fighter skates to the outside, comes back to the back of the pack.
Colonel Panic happy to have his Gemma keep at it, even though she's lead, even though it's not really making much of a difference as far as point. Oh, well, there you go. But they did give away 8 points, and I always find that an interesting...
Well, finally getting it through. I think maybe it was like one pass too many that he wanted, but you can see the result, 17-8 as opposed to 5-0. You know, so...
I always sort of, if 8 is 0, then they only got a pass. Which is, I guess that's all right. That's fine. A 9-point pass is nice.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'd also like
she only got that last pass because they played that extra long. So it was only have been limited to the one pass originally.
This is when you really have to know your jammers, and you have to know that if they can push out for
it
that.
It does exhibit a lot of trust in your pack.
Yeah.
Sometimes it pays off, sometimes it doesn't.
Danielle coming fast into a really fast-moving pack as well. Using them rolling to her advantage. When you've got a pack that's sort of rolling like that, it's very, very hard to control the gaps as they happen. So if you get a pack rolling and you've got a nimble enough jammer, they really can just wriggle straight through.
So another 4 points there for Danny Hill.
Quick shout out to our sponsors at Sydney Dobie Skates, our major sponsor for the 5x5 tournament today, and also the Sydney Dogs and Cats Home.
Free Fighter fighting away to the front again for Southside. One to beat. She's got a lead jammer. Sparky taking out Vanilla Bean for Newcastle.
Outside trying to reform that magical triangle shape around the front. Not quite getting the chance. Vanilla Bean's a little bit too quick for them. She manages to get out. She is not lead jammer. Thundersled hits the deck.
So Freeway Fighter getting the 4 points, calling it off. 5 points, sorry. There was a full pass there. And lapping Vanilla Flickier Bean. Here's a look at a play by Sparky on Vanilla Bean. Hits it to the inside. Nice little shoulder pop there.
That's a little bit cheeky there by Sparky. She put a foot outside, but Vanilla Bean would not have known, so she would have, you know, done the better thing and gone back. Callie Craig going straight to the...
So we had a star pass off the line attempt from Newcastle, and a star pass violation was picked up. So Caliente on her way to the box. I don't know who has the jammer star in this situation, but Danny Hill is lead and picking up points in bunches right now.
I can see the star is on track with the pivot. Whether or not, if and when she puts it on her head, whether or not that will actually be an illegal procedure. It's going to be interesting. It'll depend on at what point in the proceedings it all came awry.
So Danny Hill again getting through for a 5-point pass. And Southside really applying the pressure right now. They've got Newcastle on the ropes and are not letting up at all.
K-Sass getting beaten up at the back of the pack. She has the pivot hat on. She's holding the jammer star in her hand. She hasn't gone to put it on yet. At the point where she puts it on, we'll find out whether the refs think it was a legal star pass or not. We know that her teammate went to the box not long after handing her the star.
Southside just keeping the Newcastle pivot slash jammer. We're not quite sure. Just sitting on them. They're not going anywhere right now. 25-point pass with the other jammer on the track. Caliente now making her way back on. Receives a start back. So it looks like That's pivot perfectly was jamming legal. For no reason. Yeah.
Really good attempt at it, but it did not work out for Newcastle that time. And Southside are only 2 points away from a 200-point lead on Newcastle at this point.
So 29-point jam there for Danny Hill.
Booger jamming for Newcastle, goes straight into that south side wall, trying to work them to the outside, making herself a space on the inside. She is a powerful jammer, and she's up one-on-one right out the front, trying to get out. Both jammers are still in the pack at this point. Lead eventually going.
Haterade is out, Haterade. But not lead jammer. So there's 5 points for Haterade. Haterade, very familiar with this stadium. A long-time Sydney Roller Derby League skater. Now applying her wares at Southside and picking up points right now as lead jammer. No, not lead jammer, sorry.
Booger was awarded lead but has ended up in the penalty box. So we will be going for a whole nother minute in this jam. Booger will be back out on track.
Well, the way she's scoring points, I'm sure they don't mind at all.
Strong hit there by Newcastle. Knocking Haterade down, but it's time star for a star pass.
Lethal receives the star. Make sure she pulls it on before the scoring pass.
Good move. Make sure she gets all of those points.
There's 5 more points to Southside, courtesy of Lethal.
Star passes. Star passes for everyone.
All the star passes here in this jam. Thunderslut holding it, stashing it.
Looked like Newcastle weren't quite sure what was happening though. Did not get out of their own jammer's way. Made it a bit of a kerfuffle. Very powerful hit there from Minnie. Thunderslut managing to make it out. Does not get a chance to put on the panty and get any points for Newcastle before the jam ends. That was a long, 2 minutes is a long time. When things like that are happening, it's
20 more points for Southside, 326-108. This one definitely out of reach. All Newcastle can do in the next 90 seconds is try to claw back a couple of those points that Sydney's Southside's put on them. Sorry.
Ruby Fighter zooming out the front, has lead. Our Newcastle blocker is still stuck in the pack, wrestling against the last couple blockers. Little hip check on the way out. Coming around now. Colonel Panic happy to get Ruby Fighter to collect as many points as possible in the dying minutes of this half.
So there's 4 points for Maryland Tantrum. So game clock is inside the jam clock here now. Southside can run it out if they want. Freeway Fighter calling it off.
Now this is the moment when we would expect to see one of our coaches calling a timeout to try and make sure that another jam is going to happen. But
well,
it looks
question,
like...
Right? If you're
oh, there it goes. Colonel Panic calls
Colonel
it.
Panic.
There's still 10 seconds left on the jam, on the period clock, so we'll be having another jam.
So Newcastle weren't going for it there. It's really interesting, as I said, they want to try to limit the points, but if we play another jam, does Southside then just get more? And it's always
exactly
a gamble
right.
either way, right?
Yeah, certainly from Newcastle's point of view, I would want to shut it down in any way possible if it just let the time run out. But KP has got some points on his brain he wants to get as many stashed as possible so that they can really have the point differential on their side when it comes to playoffs. Oh, but they love each other so much on track. Some gorgeous camaraderie there between the Southside and the Newcastle girls coming into this final jam, what we expect to be the final jam of round two of Armageddon. Southside versus Newcastle. Southside on 333 to Newcastle's 112.
As this game does sort of draw or come to its conclusion, I want to send a big shout out to Wack Russell Terrier. She played in the round one game for Southside. The very next day at scrimmage, she broke a leg, so not able to play today. So big shout out to Wack. She's part of the 5x5 family in the podcast, etc. So rest up, Wack. You'll be back out there soon enough.
And Newcastle have lead for the final jam of this game. Southside pivot has gone to the box. There's a lot of energy in the room right now. So riding the line, making sure she doesn't accidentally cut.
Last jam, Mojo Malicious in control, calls it off and brings this game to a close. Unofficial final score, Southside Derby Dolls taking out Newcastle Roller Derby League 333-112 in what was a dominant display from Southside.
So what is the team's history? So going into this match, it was really quite tight. Southside
had never beaten Newcastle. They played a home team of Newcastle before and lost. They played their travel team last year and lost by a narrow margin, and then played them in January and got blown out. So Newcastle has had the wood over Southside, but Southside reversing their fortunes here today.
This is what I mean by the amazing preparation that Southside have been doing for this tournament. They are reigning champions. They're coming back in to regain their... Sorry, I'm getting attacked by pure energy. They are here to defend their title. It matters a lot to them, and they're working very, very hard for it.
So Southside getting the adulation of their crowd now. To the victors go the spoils. Newcastle coming up shortly, but directly after the game, we will have a quick interview with some of the captains from the two teams, and then we'll throw to our trackside trivia. Until the next game comes up, hell of a round here for Armageddon. I'm the Big Kahuna.
And I'm Icy Red, missing my cue.
I'm Susie from Sydney Derby Skates. We stock a wide range of products from all the best brands. Did you know that the Sydney Derby Skates website is up to date with stock levels and will only let you buy something if it's actually in stock? We pride ourselves on having awesome customer service and very quick delivery. Usually items are sent the very same day you place your order.
Now, after this round, you are firmly entrenched in the number one spot in Armageddon once again. You have a bye in round three. Coming up for you, you have Wollongong, who won in round one. And then if you saw Varsity today, what did you think of their performance?
Varsity are always strong. Those guys come out hard. So, yeah, we won't be taking our foot off the pedal in training, not for a bye round at all.
a hell of a game here today, ladies. Thank you so much. Southside winning in style, as they always do. Minnie Mouska, anything, any words for the Southside fans at home?
Thank you.
Awesome, thank you.
Can I say thanks to Inner West for hosting? What an awesome round. It's really awesome to skate here. And I want to say hi to my hometown girls at Oberon, Orange and Bathurst. Woo!
They were talented, Fairy Bled and Minnie, Southside Derby Dolls. Thank you. All right.
Hello.
How you doing? We're joined by Mojo Malicious and Moxie Monoxide from Newcastle Roller Derby League's Dockyard Dames after what must have been a very hard game. Mojo, tell us about it.
Well, I'll just start off by saying it's always a pleasure to play S2D2. They're the loveliest girls, so they put up a huge fight as always, and today they just took it away. They ran with it. It was great. Oh, sorry.
So we didn't catch much of that.
Yeah, as always, S2D2 is wonderful to play. They're just the loveliest girls, and they always bring a challenge to us, and today they came away with the win. So.
Now, Moxie, the team has been hit by some injuries and some players out. It's a rebuilding year and a time where you're quite depleted. We saw the numbers that you came in with short. How does a team prepare for a game when you're kind of not at your 100%?
The main thing that we're working on for the moment is just playing as a team, being a team, knowing what each other's going to do, predictability. We've actually got a really nice analogy that we've been using. Last year, we were banana bread. This year, we've got different ingredients, so we're trying to make something new.
What are the new ingredients this year?
Well, we're going for Anzac biscuits. Damn fine Anzac biscuits.
Everyone loves a good Anzac biscuit. Now, you come out of this game with, as I said, it was a big loss, but there were still some flashes of brilliance and the things that we know Newcastle can do well. So what do you want to capitalize on? And I guess everything should be a learning experience, right? So what are you looking to learn from this game for the next one?
For us, it's just about just doing what we know all the time, like keep it calm and just stick to what we know. It's really simple, really. Yeah, that's just, we'll build on that, become a really, really awesome team.
Newcastle Roller Derby League's Dockyard Dames, keep it simple and you'll do well. Thank you, ladies. We appreciate it.
We stock a wide range of products from all the best brands. Did you know that the Sydney Derby Skates website is up to date with stock levels and will only let you buy something if it's actually in stock? We pride ourselves on having awesome customer service and very quick delivery. Usually items are sent the very same day you place your order.